Hello, my name is Keshwani. That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I, Keshwani. Today, in this video, we'll do some problems dealing with addition and subtraction of fractions. Let's get going, shall we? We'll add and subtract fractions. Altogether, we're going to do 15 problems. The first 10 are going to be quite straightforward. The last 5 is probably where you may learn something new, something novel. Do you understand? By the way, this is the word that we came across yesterday in the last videos, demarcate. And I told you that in the next video I was going to tell you what it means. Demarcate, I was going to tell you when we learned it. We learned this word on day number 12 in our vocabulary lessons. In case you're interested in learning the word, just type in vocabulary words, day number 12, and you will learn it. Number 1. 1/8 plus 1/6. 1/8 plus 1/6. The very first thing we need to do here when we are adding or subtracting fractions is to make sure that they have the same denominators. If they do not have the same denominators, then we cannot add the numerators. We have to make the denominators the same. How can we make the denominator the same? In other words, we have to find a number that happens to be a nice multiple of both 8 and 6. A nice multiple of both 8 and 6. For example, 48 million would do nicely. So that'll be a damn silly thing to do. It's a very large number. 48 million is a multiple of both 8 and 6, but that will create a lot of extra work. That will create a lot of work. So what we're looking for is some number which is a multiple of both 8 and 6, but we would also like it to be small as possible, the least common multiplier, a multiplier that's both common to both 6 and 8, and we also like it to be as small as possible. Least common multiplier is what it's called, and this is how we find it. 8 and 6 is what we're looking for. We find the common factor here, the smallest prime number that is both a common factor of 8 and 6, which happens to be 2, and that's a 4, and that's a 3, and there is no other common factor between 4 and 3. The story stops here. 4 times 2 times 4 is 8, 8 times 3 is 24, and 24 is the smallest number. 48 would do fine, but 48 is not the least common multiplier. 24 is. So how can we convert this into 24? We have a denominator of 8 here. How can we convert this into 24? It's very simple. It is very simple. We take our first fraction and multiply it by 3 over 3. We haven't changed anything. We haven't changed this value because we are simply multiplying it by 1. Similarly, we take our second fraction and multiply it by 4 over 4. 6 times 4 is 24. 8 times 3 is 24. There we go. We have a common denominator in both of those fractions. Now we can simply add the top by the numerator. I'm not going to explain in this much detail in every single problem. This is the first problem and that's the only reason. Do you understand? So that's it. We're done. 3 times 1 is 3, 4 times 1 is 4, and at the bottom we have 24. As you can see, 24 is the common denominator, and the answer is 7 over 24. 7 over 24. This is number 2. The least common multiplier is what we're looking for. We have 2/3, we have 2/3, and 7/12. 2/3 and 7/12, we want to add them. What can we do here? Well, the least common multiplier of 3 and 12 is the 12 itself, because 12 is a multiple of 3, and 12 of course is a multiple of 12, is times 1. How can we convert this bottom into a 12? It's very simple. Multiply it by 4. 4 times 3 is 12. Since we are multiplying the bottom by 4, we just multiply the top by 4. Since we are multiplying both bottom and top by the same number, we are multiplying 2/3 by 1, we are not changing its value. That's it, we are done. So now we have 8 plus 7 over 12, which happens to be 15 over 12. We cannot leave it like this because of the fact that the top is more than the bottom, because of the fact that the numerator is more than the denominator. We cannot leave it like this. This is what is known as, if the top is more than the bottom, this is what is known as improper fraction. Improper fraction. We have to convert this into a mixed number. So 15/12 is going to be same as 12/12 and 3/12. 12/12 is just 1, and 3/12 is going to reduce. If you divide top and bottom by 3, it reduces to 1/4. So it's 1 1/4. The final answer is 1 1/4. Let's do number 3. If the numerator has to be more than the denominator, if the top happens to be more than the bottom, then we must always convert this into mixed numbers. Do you understand? You can't just leave it like this. You can't leave it in the form of an improper fraction. Number 3. 5/8 plus 7/6. Again, 8 and 6 are 48. 48 of course is a multiple of 8 and a 6, but it's not the smallest possible number. This, the least common multiplier here is not going to be 48. This is how we find it. 8 and 6 divide by 2. This becomes 4. This becomes 3. Same as before. 8 times 3 is 24. We want the first, this 8, to change into a 24. We multiply top and bottom by 3. We want this guy to multiply into 24. We multiply it by 4 over 4. Same as what we did. Same as what we did a little while ago. So this will be 15. This 4 times 7 times 4 is 24 or 28 over 24. And of course, if I were to continue, listen carefully, okay? Listen, if I were to continue, listen very carefully. If I were to continue, we could add up these two numbers, and then when we're going to realize that the top is going to be more than the bottom, because as already 28 is more than 24, we realize top is bottom more than bottom, and at that point we subtract 24, break it up like this we did here, like here, 15 over 12 became 12 over 12, and 3 over 12, we could do it at that point, or we can simply realize it right now and simply understand that this is simply 15 plus 4, see I'm taking a 4 from here, over 24, plus 24 over 24. That I broke up this 28 into a 4 and 24. 4 plus 24 is 28, so 15 plus 4 is going to be 19. 19, 24, and 24 plus 24 over 24 is 1. 19, 24, and 1 is simply 1 and 19, 24. 1 and 19, 24. Let's do number 4. There's no point in adding these two numbers and then subtracting 24 there. Just break it up right away. Number 4. Number 4. 7/6 minus 5/8. Again, 6 and 8. I don't know why I have so many of them with 6 and 8. So we already know the common denominator is 24. Common denominator is going to be 24. The least common multiplier of 6 and 8 is 24. Convert this into 24. 4 times 4 over 4 times and 3 over 3. Now this quantity and that quantity is what we're dealing with. Here we have 4 sevens are 28 over 24. Minus 15 over 24. 28 minus 15. 30 minus 15, listen carefully. 30 minus 15 would have been exactly 15, that I do know. If 30 minus 15 is 15, then 28 minus 15 must be 13. 2 less, 13 over 24. And since the top is less than the bottom, we're done. That's the final answer, 13/24 is the final answer. Let's do number 5. I want you to do number 5 by yourself. I want you to pause the video and do number 5 by yourself. While I enjoy my tea. Okay? Here we go. 3 minus 7 1/3. Go ahead, do it yourself. I'm going to give you 5 seconds for you to be able to pause and unpause the video. Pause the video and do it yourself. Once you have the answer, you can resume it. See what we can do. You could do it in a traditional way, and I hope that you did not do it in a traditional way, like this is the traditional way, the academic way, the orthodox way, the classical way, the nerdy way, the geeky way, the academic way. I hope you didn't do it in that way. Here's a quick way. What we have to understand here is that 3 minus 7 and 1/3, 3 minus 7, you see this is same as 3 minus, look at it this way, okay, let me start again. It's 3 3 minus 7 and 1 third. Well, it's 3 minus 7 and 1 third, which I can also look at it. I can view 3. 3 and how many thirds? Here we have 7. Here we have 7 and 1 thirds. How many thirds do we have here? 3 and how many thirds? 0 thirds. 3 and 0 thirds. Okay, watch what happens. Watch what happens. 3 and 0 thirds. So now we can deal with it. 3 minus 7, which is negative 4, plus, now we do our fractions. 0 third minus a 1 third. No third. 0 third minus a 1 third. It's just going to be negative 1 third. This is very simple. 3 minus 7 is, we're going to do it again. 3 minus 7 is negative 4 and a minus a third. Because there is no third here. 4 and negative 1 third. 4 and negative 1 third is exactly what we're getting. Negative 4 and a negative 4 and a negative 1 third is going to be 4. Negative 4 and 1 third. Negative 4 and 1 third. No need to do it out in a classical way. It's a waste of time. The next problem I'm going to give you also, I want you to do it yourself. But I don't want to erase this thing right away. Let's do number 6 right here. 615 minus 425. One more time. 615 minus 425. 4 over 25. Again, pause the video. I insist that you do it yourself, and once you have the answer, then you can resume it. Okay? You will learn more out of it that way. I'll give you 5 seconds again for you to be able to pause and unpause the video. When I say that I'm going to give you 5 seconds, that 5 seconds are not meant for you to be able to do the problem itself. That 5 seconds I'm giving you is just so you can pause the video and unpause the video when you're ready. So let's do it together. Number six, 615 minus 425. Again, I hope that you did not do it in a classical way, in a traditional way, in the orthodox way, in a geeky, nerdy, academic way, which is to simply start looking for the least common multiplier like this. You will do least common multiplier like this, 15 and 25. And the common factor here is 5, that gives you 3 and a 5. 5 times 5 is 75. 5 times 5 is 25. 25 times 3 is 75. The least common multiplier here is going to be 75. And then you write down, multiply this by 5 over 5, and you multiply this by 3 over 3, and you can do all of that. You could do all of that, but here's what you should have done. Here's a quicker way. Listen very carefully. Whenever we have to add or subtract, whenever we are asked to add or subtract a whole bunch of fractions, the very first thing we should do is to ask ourselves, of all the fractions that are given to us to add or to subtract, are they all in their most reduced form? Are they all in their simplest form? And if the answer is no, then go ahead and reduce the fraction, whichever fraction is not in its most reduced form, not in its most simplest form. Most simplest is not a proper English, you understand? It's not proper English. When I was trying to tell you that it's not proper English, that in itself turned out to be improper English, because I said that's not a proper English. Damn it. It's not proper English to say most simplest, you understand? I meant to say simplest. Anyway, so let's convert this into simplest form. This is already in its simplest form. 4 over 25th cannot be reduced. But this can be. 6 and 15, they do have a common factor of 3. Since they have a common factor of 3, let's divide top and bottom by 3. If you divide 6 by 3, it becomes 2. If you divide 15 by 3, it becomes 5. And now you start your story. Now we begin our story. And it becomes 2 fifth. 6 15 becomes 2 fifth minus 4 25th. This is already 25 and this is a 5. How can we make it a common denominator? It's very simple. Multiply this thing by top and bottom by 5 over 5. That's it. We're done. Now this one has a denominator of 25 and this one has a denominator of 25. And essentially 10 minus 4, which is 6 25th. And we're done. We are done. 6 24. Let's move on to the next one. By the way, before I erase this thing, if somebody were to approach you and ask you 625th is what percentage, would you be able to answer very quickly 625th is what percentage? What does the word percent mean? Percent. This is a digression. This is a digression. What does the word percent mean? Percent means exactly what it says. It means per 100. The word percent
means out of 100. So if you have a fraction and you're trying to figure out what that is in percentage, either the exact figure or an estimate, our job is to make the bottom into 100 or something as close to 100 as possible.
The bottom, we want to make the bottom into 100 or something as close to 100 as possible. How can one convert this bottom into a 100? Just multiply top and bottom by 4. And now it becomes 24 over 100, and there is your answer. 625th is 24%. 625th is 24% right here, 24 over 100. Do you understand? Sometimes you have to estimate it, and sometimes you can get the exact answer. For example, if somebody were to ask you what percentage is 7/9, I'm digressing as I said. What percentage is 7/9? 7/9 is what percentage approximately? Well, it's very simple. Multiply the top and bottom by 11. If you multiply top and bottom by 11, now top you end up at 88, bottom you end up at 99, and 99 is very close to 100, so it's about 88%.
7/9 is about 88%. Do you understand?
No, not 88%. 7 times 11 is 77. What the hell is the matter with me? It's a good thing I quote myself. Number 7. I may have to change the marker because this marker is this marker is moribund.
When did we learn the word moribund? We learned the word moribund a long time ago, I remember it, because I use this word all the time when the marker is about to die. When I need to change the marker, when the marker is about to die, we use this word moribund. I'm looking it up right here,
day number 71. Again, if you're interested in improving your vocabulary, just type in vocabulary words, day 71, and learn the word moribund. Or digress, we learned the word long time ago. Digress simply means to change the subject, to go off a topic. We're dealing
with fractions here, and all of a sudden I introduced a new topic, which is how to convert a given fraction into a percentage. We were digressing.
We learned that on day number 3. We learned that word on day number 3. Let's continue. Enough of the talk. Number 7. Number 7. Again, I want you to do it yourself. 612 minus 528 minus 936. I want you to do it yourself. You understand? Pause the video and do it yourself. Here we go. Again, we learned a little while ago that before we go gung-ho, when we are asked to add or subtract fractions, before we go gung-ho, it's always a good idea to ask ourselves, are these given fractions in their simplest reduced form? And if the answer is no, then we must reduce them. We must reduce them into their simplest possible form.
For example, 612 is just half.
It's just half. If you divide top and bottom by 6, it becomes 1 over 2. 528 is 1 quarter. And 9 over 36, 4 nines are 36, so it's 1 quarter again.
So what do you suppose we end up with?
It's very simple. We end up with a half minus a quarter, it's just 0. The answer is 0. Number 8.
Number 8.
12/18 minus 7/21 minus 4/12 minus 4/12.
What do you notice again?
Do you notice something? Yes, it's the exact same situation as before. We have a 12 and an 18 on the 12 on the top, 18 on the bottom. They have a common factor of 6. Divide top and bottom by 6. 12 divided by 6 is 2. 18 divided by 6 is 3. So we have 2/3 here. 7 and 21, that's a third. And 4 and 12, that's another third. So it's just 2/3 minus a third minus a third
two-thirds minus a third minus a third, two-thirds minus a third minus a third is just zero. Two-thirds minus a third is a third, and now the third would be zero. Number nine. Number nine. Where can we put number nine? As I said, you must do them yourself. 3/15 minus 4/25. 3/15 minus 4/25. Again, it's the same exact situation as the one we did before a little while ago. We're not going to leave it like this. We're not going to leave 15 and 25 the way they are, because in that situation, the least common multiplier would be 75, and that will end up creating a lot of work. So let's reduce it if we can. Right here, 3 and 15. Divide top and bottom by 3, it becomes 1/5. It becomes 1/5. So what we're left with here is the same exact situation as the one we did a little while ago, which is a fifth minus a 4/25. A fifth minus a 4/25, and now we make the common denominator of 25. Now we make the common denominator of 25 by multiplying it by 5 over 5, and what we end up here is 5 times 1 is 5, 5 minus 4 is 1, so it's 1/25. That's it. And if you have to answer what 1/25 is, what percentage, it's simple. Multiply top and bottom by 4, and that is 4 over 100. And the answer is 1/25 is 4%, exactly 4%. Not approximately 4%, but exactly 4%. Number 10. Number 10. What was this? This was not number 10. Number 10. Four fifteenths minus a third. Do it yourself, see what you can do. Well, the least common multiplier of 15 and a 3 is 15. So multiply this guy by 5 over 5. That's it, we're done. It's a very simple, very straightforward deal. So it's just 4 minus 1 times 5. 1 times 5 is 5. This is 4 minus 5 over 15, or negative 1/15. Negative 1/15. Number 11. The last 5, as I said in the beginning of the video, 11 through 15, you might find something interesting, you might find something useful, you might find something new, something novel. Or one may not. It's up to you. 7 minus 11 and 2/3. 7 minus 11 and 2/3. Well, we did a problem like this before a little while ago. Again, pause the video immediately before I start talking and before I start solving. Don't wait for me to remind you every time. Pause it and solve it. We did another problem just like this before. 7 minus 2/3. I want you to understand the 7 can be viewed. See, this one is 11, and how many thirds does it have? This is 11 whole, and it has 2/3. This is a 7 whole, and how many thirds does it have? It has no third. It has 0/3. It has 0/3. 7 and 0/3. If you want to read it like this, 7 and 0/3 minus 11 and 2/3. So now we can do our work. It's very simple. 4 minus 11 is negative. 4 minus 11 is negative 4, and this is this part, or if you like, I can actually show you the work if it makes it easier. 4 minus 11, this is the whole numbers, plus, we took care of the whole numbers, now we do the fractions. 0/3 minus 2/3. 4 minus 11 is negative 4, and 0/3 minus a 2/3 is 2/3. There we go. Since they are both negative quantities, we can just add them. Negative 4 and a negative 2/3 is going to be negative 4 and 2/3. Now, if you want to do it in the classical way, orthodox way, the academic way, you're more than welcome to do it, and you will find that you will have the same answer at the end. Number 12.
Number 12.
Number 12 says,
five and three quarters minus 12 and a half. 12 and a half.
Go ahead, do it yourself. I'm going to change the marker. This thing is really dying. I don't know why it's dying. I just opened it just a couple of days ago. Okay. Watch what happens, okay? Pay very close attention, because here we're going to be dealing with something new.
So again, we do the same exact thing as before. Five minus 12. Pay very close attention, as I already said it once.
Plus
three quarter minus a half. 5 minus 12 is negative 7, plus a 3 quarter minus a half is a quarter, which is not, this does not equal negative 7 and a quarter. It does not equal
negative 7 and a quarter, because in order for this to be the right answer,
this quantity also needs to be negative.
If we had a negative 7 and a negative quarter, a negative 7 and a negative quarter is indeed negative 7 and 1 quarter. But that's not what we have here. This quantity is positive. We have 3 quarters minus 2 quarters.
You see, half can be written as 2 quarters. This half right here can be written as 2 quarters. 3 quarters minus 2 quarters is a positive quarter.
So that answer is not correct. We have to be a little bit more creative. I should not have taken this much room here. I'm going to squeeze this back in here. I don't know what I was thinking.
So 5 minus a 12 plus 3 quarter minus a half. And 5 minus 12 is a negative 7, plus a quarter.
We have a problem. This is a positive quantity. So here's what we're going to do. Okay, watch what happens.
Negative 7 can be viewed as negative 6 plus a negative 1.
Would you agree that negative 6 and a negative 1 is negative 7? Of course you would agree. Why wouldn't you? You're not insane.
Plus a quarter.
Okay, watch what happens.
Negative 1 in turn can be viewed as negative 4 quarters. Negative 4 quarters and a positive 1 quarter. And this is still negative 6.
You see, one more time, we had a negative 7 and a positive quarter, a negative number and positive, we can't simply say it's negative 7 and 1 quarter. It is not. They both have to be negatives in order for us to just combine them readily. So what we do is we break up negative 7 into a negative 6 and a negative 1. And negative 1 can be written as 4 quarters. So now 4 quarters minus a quarter becomes a negative 3 quarters. And this is negative 6. Since this is negative 6 and this is negative 3 quarters, we can combine them together and it is simply negative 6 and 3 quarters. If you're not able to see this right away, that's okay. It's just there. I just want you to be open your mind. I want you to be broad-minded and understand and realize that there is a different perspective. There is a different point of view that one can take and still arrive at the same conclusion. So it's not just one right or wrong way of doing it. You can look at it in several different ways. So now we're going to do it the classical way, the traditional way, the orthodox way, the geeky way, the nerdy way, the academic way, the way your math teacher will teach you, which is simple.
5 3/4 minus 12 and 1 half, and we'll see what happens. 5 times 4 is 20, 20 plus 3 is 23, so it's 23 quarters minus, but you see, let's continue. 2 times 12 is 24, 24 plus 1 is 25, is 25 halves. Watch what happens. This is a half this is a half and this is a quarter, so we have to convert this quantity. 25 halves is same as 50 quarters. You see, multiply top and bottom by 2. I hope you're able to see that. So now we have a 4 here, we have a 4 here, we have a common denominator, and we can continue. 23 quarters minus 50 quarters. So far, it's a very traditional method. There is nothing unique about it. There is nothing novel about it. I wrote down the word novel and then I erased it. I never told you when we learned it. Novel means unique, one of a kind, out of the ordinary. Do you understand? Not something that is pedestrian, hackneyed, mundane, banal. All of these words we learn, and you're going to learn all of these words when you learn the word novel, because we covered all of these words, hopefully, on the same day. Day number 13. Because I'm assuming that if you're watching these videos, you're probably preparing for one of these tests, GRE or GMAT or SAT or ACT or TEAS or HESIs. And if you're preparing for any of these tests, having a good vocabulary, having good vocabulary is a must. Learn the words. You understand? Just type in vocabulary words, day number 17, just type in vocabulary words, day 17, and watch the videos and you will learn the word novel. And you will also learn some antonyms. So this approach has nothing novel about it. This is very standard, very, very traditional method. Let's continue. 23 minus the 50. 23 minus the 50, it's going to be how much? 25, listen carefully. 25 minus the 50 would have been negative 25, you see? 25 minus 50 is negative 25. Since it's 23, it's going to be negative 27. Negative 27 quarters. Negative 27 quarters, which I'm going to write it on this side here because I need the room. Negative 27 quarters. This part right here is this, which can be written as negative 24 quarters minus negative 3 quarters. I'm squeezing it here because I don't want to erase this part. You see that? This quantity is negative 27 over 4. Negative 27 over 4, negative 27 quarters, which can be written as negative 24 quarters and negative 3 quarters. Negative 24 quarters is a negative 6. And negative 3 quarters right here. Voila. We get exact same thing. Obviously, we're going to get the exact same thing. We're not going to get two different answers just because we're doing it in two different methods, obviously. That would be damn silly thing to say. Math is math. Math is the only thing we have. Math is the only thing we human have, which is absolute. It doesn't change. It doesn't change with culture. It doesn't change with the method. Let's do the next one, shall we? Number 13. Let's leave this here. Let's do number 13 here because it's a traditional method. You don't need this method. It's this method that I should probably say for a while. Or what the hell? Number 13. 24 and a half minus 3/8. Watch what happens here. Watch what happens. Again, if you like, you can do it in a traditional way. It's up to you. You can do it in a traditional way. Entirely up to you. But here's the non-traditional way. 24 minus 3 is 21. I'll tell you what. Let me do it systematically so that you don't get confused. 24 and a half. Half has how many 8? Half is made up of how many 8? A half is made up of 4/8. 4/8 make a half. Minus 3/8. Now we can begin our work. 24 minus a 3. 24 minus a 3. Plus, I shouldn't have to do the baby steps, you understand? 4/8 minus 3/8. 4/8 minus a 3/8. 24 minus a 3 is 11. And 4/8 minus a 3/8 is an 8. And they are both positive quantities, which if you're going to add them, the answer is 21. Did I make a mistake? It should be 21. 24 minus 3 is 21. 21 and 1/8.
21 and 1/8. Let's do the next one, number 14, the penultimate one. Number 14.
Three and five nine minus five and two thirds.
Five and two thirds. Well, what can we do? Well, first thing we have to understand here. First, think of these as, even though they are not exact, there is no such thing as a 5/9 of a dollar exactly, and there is no such thing as the exact 2/3 of a dollar, because 2/3 is 66.666, so you're not going to have 2/3 of a dollar would be 66.66 and 2/3 of a cent. You cannot get a 2/3 of a cent, but think of these as dollars and change. So we have 3 minus 5, those are the whole numbers, and now we're going to subtract 5/9, we're going to subtract 2/3 from 5/9. So if you try to subtract 2/3 from a 5/9, the problem that we run into is that this was a denominator of 9, this one has a denominator of 3. That won't do. We need a denominator of 9. So the very first thing we can do is multiply this fraction by 3 over 3.
We haven't changed anything.
It is still 5 and 2/3. 5 and 2/3 times 3 over 3 is still 5 and 2/3, because 3 over 3 is just 1. Now we can begin our work. Watch what happens, okay? And you're going to see, we're going to have a nice juxtaposition. We're going to have a nice juxtaposition of a situation here and the situation that we're dealing with here. This situation is very nice, very sweet, very easy, very straightforward, very simple, because it turns out that 24 is more than 3. We got a positive number, and our half is more than 3/8. So we get another positive number. Since we have two positive numbers, we simply add the two. If we had two negative quantities, if this were a negative quantity and this were a negative quantity, we simply would have added the two numbers with the negative sign in the front. Here it's going to get a little bit more complicated. This is similar to the one that we did before. Watch what happens. So we have, what we end up here is 3 and 5/9 minus 5 and 6/9. Let's begin our story, okay? 3 minus 5 plus, now we deal with this one, 5/9 minus a 6/9. 5/9 minus a 6/9. Okay, watch what happens. Actually, this is also simpler. Yeah, this is not a complicated one either. I'll tell you why in a second. 3 minus 5 is negative 2, plus 5/9 minus 6/9 is negative 1/9. Okay, listen very carefully. As I was doing it, I thought we were going to run into situations where this quantity is going to become a positive number, in which case we'll have to borrow a 1 from here and do what we did before a little while ago. Not this one, the one before. But here, this one is also a negative quantity. 5/9 minus 6/9 is just a negative 1/9. 5/9 minus 6/9 is a negative 1/9. This is a negative 2. We are done. We don't have to do anything. The answer is 2 and negative 1/9. Negative 2 and 1/9 is the final answer. If you like, you can do the exact same problem here in a traditional method. And you will see it will be the same answer. Of course it will be the same answer. Why would the answer be different? Let's do it here, shall we? It will have to be the same answer, obviously.
So we have 3 and 5/9 minus 5 and 2/3. 5 and 2/3.
Watch what happens. 3 nines are 27. 27 plus 5. 27 plus 3 is 30. 30 plus 2 is 32. So it's 32/9 minus 3 fives are 15. 15 plus 2 is 17. 17/3. Here we have a denominator of 3. Here we have a denominator of 9. So we have to make it the same. Voila. You with me? So now we have a denominator of 9 in both places. So we end up with 32 minus 17 times 3. How much is 17 times 3? It's very simple. 10 times 3 is 30. 10 times 3 is 30. And 7 threes are 21. And 7 threes are 21. 30 plus 21 is 51. And then, of course, over 9. Okay, listen carefully one more time. 32 minus 52 would have been exactly 20. 32 minus 52 would have been exactly 20. Because it is 32 minus 51, it is 19. It is negative 19. Negative 19 can be written as, let me squeeze it on this side a little bit. Negative 19 over 9 can be written as negative 18 over 9
and a negative 1/9.
18/9, negative 18/9 and a negative 1/9 is same as negative 19/9, which is what this quantity is. Negative 18/9 is same as negative 2. Negative 2 and a negative 1/9, so it's negative 2 and 1/9. It is negative 2 and 1/9. Same as here, of course. It's not going to give you a different answer, obviously. What the, this was 14. This was the penultimate one. Let's do the 15, the last one. And I know I have told you this thing probably a zillion times as to when we learned about penultimate. I'm going to tell you one more time in the event that you are new. I believe it was day number 11. I'm going to check. Yes.
This question was the penultimate. Something we learned on day number 11.
Again, just type in vocabulary words. Vocabulary words, day 11, and learn the word. Penultimate is just a fancy way of saying second to the last.
This was the penultimate question. This was number 14. Now we're going to do the last one. Let's erase this part. Which part should we erase? Let's erase the traditional part, because the traditional part is more straightforward. Let's leave that there. Number 15.
Do it yourself. This is the last one. Pause the video. As soon as I pause the video, do it yourself, both methods. Try to do this problem, both methods yourself. Here we go.
3 2/7 minus 5 1/14.
5 1/14. As I said, do it yourself. See what happens. I'm going to give you 5 seconds for you to be able to pause and unpause the video. Again, one more time I'm going to read to you. 3 2/7 minus 5 1/14. Here we go.
3 minus 5 plus 2/7 minus 1/14. 2/7 minus 1/14. The problem is this one has a denominator. This fraction has a denominator of 7. This fraction has a denominator of 14. We need to have the same denominators. So we have to multiply this quantity by 2 over 2. See, multiply this quantity by 2 over 2. Oh, I shouldn't have done it now. This made a mess.
So now we have 4 over 14 minus 1 over 14. Are you able to see that? I made a bloody mess out of it, didn't I? So once you multiply by 2 over, multiply 2/7 by 2 over 2, what we end up here is, so this is 3 minus 5 is this quantity right here, plus this quantity 4 over 14, 4/14 minus 1/14. So here we end up 3 minus 5 is negative 2 plus 4/14, 4/14 minus 1/14 is 3/14. Since this is negative 2 plus negative 2 plus 3/14, it is not equal to negative 2 and 3/14. It's not equal to that. This is a positive quantity, this is a negative quantity. It's not going to work. Do you understand? So here's what we have to do. We take this one and we break it up into two parts. We break it up into negative 1 plus a negative 1. Okay, watch what happens. And plus this quantity. See? Negative 2 can be written as negative 1, and negative 1 plus negative 1 is negative 2. And this thing simply comes down. Now negative 1 in turn can be written as negative 14 over 14, and this is just 3/14, and this is just negative 1. Now we have negative 14 and a positive 3/14. Negative 14/14, negative 14/14, and a positive 3/14 is going to give us negative 11/14, and this is going to give us negative 1. Negative 1 and a negative 11/14 is going to give us negative 1 11/14. That's our final answer. If you were to do this problem in a traditional way, you will find that you will get the same answer. Let's do it here.
So we have 3 2/7 3 and 2 7th minus 5 and 1 14th. 5 and 1 14th.
Okay, let's begin our process. This is just a traditional method. There's nothing new about it. There's nothing novel about it, nothing unique about it. Simple, straightforward, traditional, orthodox, classical, academic method. 3 times 7 is 21. 21 plus 2 is 23. 23 7th minus 5 times 14 is 70. How do I know that 5 times 14 is 70? Because I know that 10 times 14. I know that 10 times 14 is 140. 10 14s are 140. If 10 14s are 140, then 5 14 must be half of 140, which is 70. Plus 1, 71 over 14. Again, the problem that we run into here is that, here we have a denominator of 7, here we have a denominator of 14. That won't do. That won't do at all. We have to take this second, we have to take this first fraction and multiply it by 2 over 2. Which is what was going on here. You see that? So now we have 23 times 2, which is 26, minus 71 over 14. Let's see how much it is. 71 and a 26 subtracted, we get, this becomes 6. 11 minus 6 is 5, and 6 minus 2 is 4. We end up with negative 45. Negative 45, 14th. Negative 45, 14th. Did I make a mistake someplace? Oh, this should have been 23 times 2 is 46. You see, they were not agreeing. We need a 1 here. I wasn't going to get a 1 out of this. This is more than a 1. I wasn't going to get a 1 out of this one. 45 is a half a lot more than a, we need 1. We need almost about 2, and this is much more than a 2. I made a mistake someplace. The mistake I made is here. 23 times 2 is 46, not 26. It's a good thing I caught myself. It's a good thing I caught myself right away. And we subtract 46 from here. And 6 minus 4 is going to be 2. We end up with 25, not 45. We end up with 25, negative 25 over 14, which can be written as negative 25 14th, can be written as negative 14th 14th plus a negative 9 14th. Let's see. 14 plus 9, does it add up to 24? No, 14 plus 9 will be 23. We need 25. It should be 11. Of course it should be 11 because that's what we have here. There we go. Which makes perfect sense if you think about it. If you think about it, it makes perfect sense because 25 minus 14, 25 minus 15, listen carefully, 25 minus 15 would have been exactly 10. Since 25 minus 15 is 10, we don't have 15, we have 14, it should be 11. So negative 14 over 14, negative 14th 14 plus a negative 11th 14. Negative 14th 14 is just negative 1. It's just negative 1. Plus a negative 11th 14. Since they are both negative quantity, we can put them together like this. Negative 1 and 11th 14 is exactly what we had here. There should be no surprise, as I said before several times. You understand? I hope you got something out of it. Bye now.